The KETV NewsWatch 7 I-Team uncovers new details on an Omaha operation selling bogus IDs and social security numbers.
Now, it's a case we first exposed a month ago, and I-Team investigator Christy Anderson is live with new information. Christy?
Rob, you'll remember in July we found a man using someone else's social security number, and back then federal investigators told us they were cracking down on that type of fraud, and now unsealed court documents prove just that.
You bought one from someone?
Yeah.
In July, when the I-Team approached undocumented worker Carlos Gonzalez, he told us he was using a stolen social security number. Gonzalez said he bought that identification on the street in South Omaha, an underground business we now know federal agents were well aware of. This summer, Immigration and Customs Enforcement agents watched these apartments on South 29th Street closely. Court documents obtained by the I-Team reveal inside apartment number 17, a theft operation was in full swing. Investigators were led to that apartment by a man named Isidro Candelario Urias, known as El Primo on the street. According to court records, in June and July, El Primo met with undercover agents at both Hanscom Park and a bar on South 24th Street. In each case, he reportedly made deals to sell fake documents. Agents were able to buy counterfeit ID cards from South Dakota, Kansas, and Nebraska for $140 each. Candelario Urias also led authorities here to a tenant named Telesforo Luangas Paella. In his apartment, agents discovered all the necessary equipment to make fake documents: computers, heat laminators, digital cameras, and blank laminate from the Department of Motor Vehicles, State of Texas, Department of Justice, the Immigration and Naturalization Services. Also found ID cards from 11 different states, a birth certificate, and a social security card.
Like I said, it's not just illegal aliens who are obtaining these documents, it's also criminals, criminal organizations, or worse. And that's one of the reasons that we want to target these people.
And both of those men currently being held on felony charges. As for where they got the equipment to make the fake IDs, ICE can't tell us that. It's still under investigation. And you might be wondering what happened to that man who admitted using the stolen Social Security number. Well, we alerted the U.S. Attorney's Office and the Social Security Administration to what we found, and both say they are investigating.
All right. Thank you, Christy.